Hi, Chris Columbus here for Turner Classic Movies. It is an honor to share my five favorite March picks with you. And it was difficult because there are so many great films being shown in March. My first pick is Singing in the Rain, an amazing, almost flawless movie. And you can say that about very few movies. I showed Singing in the Rain to my 16-month-old granddaughter, who was absolutely absorbed in the musical numbers, more so than any Disney animated films. She loved it, and I go back to it once or twice a year. I just think it's an amazing film, and the chemistry between the then, I think it was 39-year-old Gene Kelly and the 19-year-old Debbie Reynolds is kind of amazing when you take into account that Gene Kelly made her life miserable, particularly in the Good Morning sequence, which is one of my favorite sequences in the film, probably my favorite musical number. In that sequence, Debbie Reynolds' feet were bleeding when they stopped, and she had to be hospitalized for 2 days afterwards. And you can't tell when you watch the film, that sequence is just so charming and so filled with life, you would never guess that there was any tension behind the set. My next pick is David Lean's Great Expectations. Truly wonderful film, and the black and white photography alone is some of the most stunning I've ever seen. The performance of Alec Guinness, one of his best. The interesting thing about Great Expectations is I didn't see it until around 1989 when I was prepping to direct Home Alone. And the first 20 minutes of that film, of Great Expectations, inspired me. It actually taught me how to direct a film from the point of view of a child, which essentially was the entire Home Alone film. So I thank David Lean for that, and I watch the film at least once a year. Billy Wilder's The Apartment, an absolutely stunning film. Features two of my favorite performances in film history, Jack Lemmon and Shirley MacLaine. But the real revelation to me in The Apartment, now remember, I was a kid who grew up with my three sons with Fred McMurray. And to see Fred McMurray's darkly complex role in The Apartment was absolutely stunning. It's a companion piece to Billy Wilder's Double Indemnity as well. But the most heartbreaking scene in the film to me is when Shirley MacLaine, who is desperate, calls Fred McMurray at his home on Christmas morning. He's unwrapping presents with his wife and kids. It's just beautiful and heartbreaking all at the same time. The Apartment taught me that great comedy can go hand in hand with an underlying sense of darkness. And I try to keep that in mind when I do a comedy. John Ford's The Quiet Man, a perfect film for St. Patrick's Day, March 17th. And one of the things I love about the picture, again, is that it's a great comedy, but there's this underlying sense of darkness, particularly in John Wayne's character who killed a guy in the ring, and he's carrying that with him throughout the entire picture. One of the other things I love about the film is the beautiful Technicolor cinematography. It's just absolutely gorgeous, and it makes Ireland look like this really wonderful, magical place. Interesting thing, I worked with Maureen O'Hara back in 1990, and she told me a great story about being on the set of The Quiet Man. She said that the cinematographer hated the way the film was being shot. So every day, he would write on the slate, S-U-P, and all of the dailies had that on the slate. And I said, well, what does that mean? She said, it means shot under protest. And ironically, the cinematographer won the Oscar for best cinematography that year. My next pick, or picks, I actually am picking two films, I'm cheating a little bit, but they are related, are Steven Spielberg's Duel and a movie called Brian's Song. Now, these weren't technically theatrical films. These were television movies of the week. But back in the day, we really looked forward to every Tuesday night because we didn't know what genre we were gonna get. With Steven Spielberg's Duel, which is literally still one of the most exciting, thrilling rides you'll ever have, I remember running to school the next day, and all of my friends, all we could talk about was Duel. It was like the greatest movie we had ever seen up until that point. And you realize it's 1971, so technically we weren't seeing movies that technically proficient on television at the time. And it's the brilliance of Steven Spielberg. And you look back and of course that's the guy who should have directed Jaws. On the opposite side of the spectrum, while not a great technical achievement in lighting and cinematography, is Brian's Song. Now, Brian's Song was one of the most emotional experiences I've had watching a film up until that point. It basically was a pre-Godfather James Caan playing football player Brian Piccolo, and he gives a wonderfully charming, funny performance, but it's Billy Dee Williams who plays Gale Sayers who steals the movie for me in a particularly moving moment when he eulogizes Brian Piccolo. I remember sobbing the first time I saw it, and I looked over at my gruff, blue-collar uncle who was crying harder than I was, and I'd never seen him cry. Brian Song is just a brilliant film.